toys, and other collectibles. These are the things that have consumed every collector. Their mission: to expand their growing collection, to seek out new forms of plastic shaped like their favorite characters, to boldly defy what it means to be an adult. Collector's Log, Earth Date 0303.2020. We are orbiting around the Brooklyn Quadrant. I have finally acquired 6-scale Star Trek figures produced by Quantum Mechanics, spearheaded by Star Trek scholar Nanjin Schubert Tam. Having been available for 3 years, I am currently kicking myself for not getting these sooner, for their quality is undeniable and worthy of adoration. A little disclaimer, I am not what you would call a die-hard Star Trek fan, a Trekkie, if you will, or Trekker. Apparently there is a distinction, but I'm not aware of it. That being said, I was a fan of The Next Generation. I didn't watch it religiously when it was on TV back in the 90s, but I did watch enough of it to know all of the names of the characters. So growing up in the 90s, The Next Generation was my Star Trek, Picard was my captain. So, I was a casual fan. Key word, was. I was a casual fan. Recently, I've been binge-watching The Next Generation on Blu-ray, all the way from the first episode, with every intention of completing it all the way to the last episode. And my god, it is such a phenomenal show. I'm loving every second of it. I have now officially become a Trekkie. GQ of the Q Continuum, I have joined your ranks. I am obsessed with The Next Generation. I just wish there were more Star Trek shows like it. A simpler era. Before the dark times. Before the Abrams. I'm just kidding. I'm sure there are fans of the Kelvin timeline. I'm just not a huge fan of it. Those movies are competently made. They're just not Star Trek for me. Well, enough about my history with Star Trek, on with the figures. If it's not clear by now, these figures are just awesome. Save for Sulu, every character you see here, Kirk, Spock, Picard. One look at these and you can tell that there's so much passion poured into them. With a level of attention to detail that's bordering on obsessive, it makes you wonder, how the hell did these come out at $180? Those were Hot Toys prices, back in 2006. And boy, let me tell you right now, you did not get sculpts like these back in that day. You don't have to look at this from a certain angle or light it in a particular way to see who this is. Immediately, you can tell that this is William Shatner as James T. Kirk, captain of the USS Enterprise, and future spokesperson for Priceline.com. The stock body serves its purpose. It's well made, very sturdy. It has some ratchet joints under the armpits, which helps for the neutral stance when all you want to do is have the arms close to the body. And as you can see here, once you get Kirk or anyone else that's wearing a similar outfit into a dynamic pose, you begin to lose that realism. And it's understandable given that these are not Fison bodies, where every joint and gap is covered by silicone rubber. Coupled with form-fitting outfits that are also made of very thin material, any crazy poses and it's just gonna look unnatural. The same thing happens with Hot Toys' Spider-Man figures. Look, these are Star Trek characters. They're not Star Wars, they're not Marvel, they're not DC. If you want to treat them like they're some kind of magic ninja or give them an Iron Man 3-point landing pose, well, I wouldn't. But if you want to, get a Fison body and never look back. So yeah, these stock bodies, they're great. They serve their purpose. As I mentioned in my last review of Caustic Plastic's Italian Stallion figure, it's not often that I come across a portrait that legitimately wows me. And these set of figures, save for one, have me feeling the same way that I felt about Rocky. And these sculpts, they just have so much personality and realism to them. There are two points of frustration regarding portraits that I want to address. One being the hand-waving of opinions from someone that's not a collector, such as my wife or your friends or whoever in your life that is not a figure enthusiast. If a non-collector tells you that the thing you bought looks nothing like the actor it's based on, it doesn't look like the character or the actor. Hate to break it to you, but that's it. Take it or leave it. My wife does not know her William Shatner, her Leonard Nimoy, or her George Takei. But when I showed her the original series, just like Rocky, she was astonished. And when I showed her Episode 3's Anakin produced by Hot Toys, well, let's just say I'm starting to reevaluate myself a little bit. And here is the weak link of my Star Trek 6th scale collection. It's a decent George Takei sculpt, but it doesn't carry with it the same wow factor that I got from Kirk, Spock, and Picard, with Picard being my favorite out of them all. I prefer the prototype, where there is no smirk, and that little punch of realism and accuracy is, it's just much better, in my opinion. So once again, this is a decent sculpt, but it does not reach the level of standards that were set by Kirk, Spock, and Picard. Like Kirk and Spock before him, here's another figure that has me and my wife in awe. The level of detail, realism, and personality is just unreal, and I cannot believe I have a figure of this quality at this price point in my collection. Which brings me to my second point of frustration, the inevitable comparisons to Hot Toys figures. Yes, I know, they've been in the game for a long time and they've set many standards. That is true. But when you have figures like this, where in my opinion, have actually gone beyond Hot Toys quality, and something like Rocky, Hot Toys are no longer the standard. They still produce nice figures, but like I mentioned in my Obi-Wan review, 7 out of 10 will feature a 70 to 80% likeness to the actor, and the remaining 3 are dead on, such as Count Dooku and the most recent Bucky figure, as well as Infinity War Thor. So when other reviewers, whom I respect a great deal, say something like almost Hot Toys quality or close to Hot Toys quality, and I'm thinking, come on guys, look at this. WTF is this ish? Well, it's all my opinion. I think these have exceeded Hot Toys, and I stand by that. As there is light, there's also dark. And that comes in the form of QMX's uncertain future with this line. As of this recording, Nanjin Shubertam is no longer associated with QMX. He was the conductor of this orchestra. Without him, the future's looking bleak. And like the final episode of Star Trek The Next Generation, all good things must come to an end. I really hope this line continues some way or another. It will be most illogical if it ends here.